All right, so welcome back. So I showed you there how we can determine, with using a sling psychrometer, how we can find the wet and dry bulb temperatures and then use the scale that we have on the side of the psychrometer to determine the relative relative humidity. Now, where did that scale come from? And that's typically for use in the field. So when we're doing more calculations, what we're going to use these psychrometric charts. And so let me show you what those are all about. So here's a psychrometric chart. And one thing we want to notice right away is that these are all for atmospheric pressure here. So here we got the different temperatures. So we got dry bulb temperature down here on our horizontal axis. We have our wet bulb and dew point temperature scales, and they come down from the upper left and come down and hit the dry bulb temperature at some point down here. And what we'll find is when we look at on the next slide, I'll have more details. But this point right here where the wet bulb and the dry bulb intersect, because that's where the dry bulb is the same as a wet bulb, that's when we have our 100% relative humidity. And then as we go down, these curves going up this direction are all our different relative humidities at 50 and 10%. All right, some other information we have on here is we have our humidity ratio that we can get from this chart, as well as the partial pressure of the vapor. Now for this mixture enthalpy, remember that this is, if you look at the overall enthalpy, H, right? And usually we looked at this per unit mass of dry air. So what that equals is our enthalpy of air plus the humidity ratio times the enthalpy of the saturated vapor at that particular temperature. All right, and so that's useful because we're going to use that a lot when we look at, say, the mass flow rate. If we have the mass flow rate of some going in of some moist air times the enthalpy of whatever that stuff going in, that's going to be equal to our mass flow rate of the air that's entering times this mixture enthalpy value. All right, so whenever we're looking at this moist air contribution, now we just need to know this mass flow rate of air. And then this whole value here we can get from our mixture enthalpy off our chart. So again, we'll have some practice with that, but I just want to give you a sense of where that's coming from.
There's one more thing I wanted to discuss when it concerns the mixture enthalpy. So I'm coming to this a separate slide to really highlight this. But when we look at overall mixture enthalpy, we have HA plus omega HG. Now, we got two places we can get this information from the psychrometric chart, which we just talked about. And we can also get it from table A22 and A3, A4, and any other ones from the vapor saturation table. All right, so the thing I want to highlight here is that on the psychro chart, the HA, the enthalpy for air, is zero. Let me do this differently. Equals zero. And let's just say we're in BTUs per pound, if we're in English, at 0 degrees Fahrenheit. For table A22, HA is equal to zero BTUs per pound at 0 degrees Kelvin. So you can imagine what the value that we're going to get for enthalpy for air at 0 degrees Fahrenheit versus 0 degrees or zero Kelvin is going to throw things off a bit. So you got to be very careful when you use, if you want to kind of mix and match the mixture enthalpy or the enthalpy of air that you get from these two different areas. Now on the vapor side, you're okay. So HV vapor is okay. All right. They use the same datum. So let's put that here. So same datum, the same place they start from, so that works here. Here we have a different datum for the enthalpy of air. So be very careful. Now what you can do, what you could do, is from the chart you could have your mixture enthalpy, so HA plus your humidity ratio times the enthalpy of the vapor. And this is from the chart. So you could take that and you could add on the enthalpy of the air at 460 degrees Rankine, or 0 degrees Fahrenheit. If you do that, then you would get the equivalent of HA plus omega HV, all from tables. All right. So if you did that, that would be okay. Again, it's kind of convoluted, so I would say just stick to the table or stick to the chart. But I just want to highlight that you can do that if you want to mix and match, but be very careful as you do that.
So here's the detailed version of the psychrometric chart. Now, this one's in Fahrenheit, so this is English units. All right, but again, we have dry bulb temperature down here. Here's our relative humidity. Oops. Relative humidity. Let me erase that here, clean that up. Relative humidity here in the middle. So each one of those curves going up and to the right. We have our wet bulb or saturation temperature values here coming from the upper left. Now, notice here, right? So it's kind of two sets of lines coming here. So here's 60 degrees Fahrenheit, 70 degrees Fahrenheit for the wet bulb temperatures. And you can see there's the line that there, that bold black ones for 70. And there's a bold black one here for 60, one right here for 65. But then you also have these lines coming down here, and this is the specific enthalpy of moist air. All right, and that's kind of that what's said on the previous slide. This is that mixture enthalpy. All right, and so it's coming down from the upper left, and you can see the values there, 20, 25, 30. So, and those lines don't quite go straight through because the lines are going straight through, starting in the upper left, going down, are the wet bulb temperature. So you just have to kind of see some of them line up, some of them don't quite. So just be careful with those. All right, we also have specific volume, right, over here coming down. So specific volume of dry air. So we have those values we can get off this chart as well. And then here's humidity ratio. So it doesn't actually have partial pressure of the vapor in here, but you can calculate that using the relative humidity. All right, so we'll get back to this chart and do an example with it here in just a bit. All right, so let's do an example. And actually, we'll just go back to what we did from the recording when we had our sling psychrometer in my office. All right, here's the dry bulb temperature down here. So we were at 70, and the wet bulb temperature was 58. So we've been right this line right here. All right, so 70 and 58. So let's see if we can line those up. So if we come up to 70, the black one here, and I'll line up with right about there, two lines down. Oops, get up there. All right, so let's look on here. Yes, yeah, so right below the 50% line, all right, relative humidity. So it looks like this, you know, sling psychrometer, right? You could see there was some hysteresis. It would move around a little bit. I guess it's right near that 50% that we had measured there. On your handout, the example there is, what if we had a dry bulb temperature of 68? So somewhere right here. And we had a wet bulb of 60 degrees Fahrenheit. So 60 is up here. So that one's a little bit easier. Well, two lines to the left of 70 and right on the 60 line. All right, so we'd be right in here. All right, it's a little bit above 60% relative humidity. All right, the other thing we could find there, and actually in both cases, we can just slide over here to the left. If I can do this straight enough, dipping down a little bit, back up, come back down. All right, so we can see the humidity ratio is 0.0095. And so ultimately, this is all coming out of the part where we did with the adiabatic saturator process, adiabatic saturation process, to figure out what is the humidity ratio. So we've just been able to calculate that here based on using this psychrometric chart. All right, so there's an example, and then we'll come back to this and when we do some other calculations. So as I showed you on the other chart, we have the 70 degrees Fahrenheit for the dry bulb. If we look up where that hits, and I got to get through these relative humidity percentages, but right here it hits that 70 degrees Fahrenheit for the wet bulb temperature. So right there it shows us is the dew point temperature. All right. So where we'd hit a certain dew point if we travel across from left to right. So if we're going this way on the chart, so say we start out here at 100 degrees for our dry bulb temperature, and there's 100 degrees, go straight up, and we're going to maintain the humidity ratio. So the humidity ratio is pounds of water or mass of water to the mass of dry air, and that's not going to change until something starts condensing. So if we cool it, starting at 100, and if we cool it, it's going to move to the left until it hits, right, our dew point, our 70 degrees. So that's why it's called a dew point. And effectively what it's doing is this process here. So if we look at our vapor dome, that's a really bad drawing here. Let me try it again here. All right, so we look at our vapor dome on our TV diagram. So here's T and V, and we have this plot going across here. And we're out here. So this is let's say we start out at this is at 100 degrees Fahrenheit right here. And then we cool down at this constant partial pressure vapor, or we could say at a constant humidity ratio. We come down this curve until we get here. This point right here at this partial pressure is 70 degrees Fahrenheit. So what we have coming down this partial pressure curve is what's shown on this table by moving straight across, right, at some constant humidity ratio value.